Hey guys! So I posted a video a while back, like, I don't know, 2 years ago, and it was like how to get naturally pink lips, you know, that kind of thing. And I was so awkward in that video, and I just wanted to apologize because I didn't talk, I didn't edit, like, I did nothing, and I just kind of stared like straight into the camera the entire time. So, I kind of want to apologize for that and give you guys a new video that kind of goes more into depth and isn't so creepy. So, so basically all you need is a toothbrush of any sorts, doesn't really matter. And I just have like a glass of water here that you will be dipping the toothbrush into later. And I had a lot of people ask me if the temperature of the water matters. Not really. This is just like room temp. It doesn't matter if it's cold, hot, burning, whatever. Don't suggest you put like lava water on your lips. I won't be responsible for like any injuries. So anyways, let's get into it. And as you can see, my lips are kind of chapped and, you know, just kind of gross. And I have, like, the dead skin, they're pale, not very pretty. Anyway, so, take your water, take your toothbrush, dip your toothbrush into the water, get it nice and wet. You know, just enough so that the bristles aren't, you know, like, gonna rip your skin off. You know, decent. And then you just go at it and start brushing your lips with your toothbrush, so... just like that. And yeah, it's kind of awkward to talk and do this, but you know, whatever. I'm gonna do it for you guys. And really just make sure that you get like into the corners of your mouth, because that's where a lot of the dead skin will be. So you want to get the entire mouth, not just like in the middle. And then, yeah, basically just do that to the top and bottom lip until they're pink and soft. So, yeah, just gonna like turn this up. You can listen to music while I brush my lips. And don't judge my playlist, because I just put on like a random station, so it's just playing songs, so if a weird one shows up, it's not my fault. Yeah. Also, depending on how sensitive your lips are, you kind of want to be careful, you know, like you don't want to scrape your lips off, so... you know, if you have really sensitive lips, just be a little more gentle. But, other than that, it's just whatever you're comfortable with. And, I mean, you could go until your lips are red. You won't damage your lips unless you're, like, crazy rough or something. But, other than that, you should be fine with whatever you're comfortable with. And so, you can kind of see now that my lips aren't like, they don't look chapped, they look nice, they look, you know, just soft and luscious. And I'm kind of a perfectionist, so I try to get like every single corner, but obviously you don't have to do that if you don't want to, but you know, if I'm gonna do something, I'm gonna do it perfect. So, yeah. Okay. Anyways, after that, you should be able to feel that there's no more dead skin on your lips. And you can tell a little bit that they're pinker than when I started. So, after that, if they aren't dry, then you could just take, like, a towel and just, like, kind of pat your lips. Don't rub them and irritate them, but just, like, pat them a little bit until they're dry. And then, I have been loving this EOS, little chapstick, whatever. I use the mint, and so that's what I use. You can use, Vaseline. I had people ask me if they could use Vaseline or whatever else they had, if you aren't a big fan of chapstick. Lip gloss, lipstick, whatever. But, show you, like, this...